I want to get your take on this. I mean, do you consider her a front runner in this race, and was this a smart move for her?
Definitely not a smart move. I don't think she's going to be a front runner. I think it's probably offensive to the district to have somebody kind of swoop in and say, I'll represent you now, considering she didn't do much for the district she was in. I feel like she's coming in as a loser because she's kind of giving up her district. She's already in her mind lost that district, and now she's finding a place here. I think she's looking for a job. I don't know if she's really committed to the constituents. You know, we're talking about, you know, Ken Buck did represent his constituents. I didn't agree with most of what he did, but he represented his constituents, and you really have to know the community and those rural communities. You really have to have connections, and I just don't see that that she has that.
Jake, I want to get your take because we haven't heard. Do you think this was a smart strategy for her political wise?
I think it was her only out, to be honest, Ashley. I think that she was, and she so much as admitted in that video you previewed there, she couldn't win the third. So at that point, she made a decision politically to where else can I go to stay a member of Congress? And to me, that reflects her district shopping more to be able to stay a part of what she determined to be the swamp. She's now so infatuated with said swamp that she's going to go 250 miles from her home to another district of which she's never lived in to try to be a member of Congress to represent that swamp. And I just think that's just bad taste.
I mean, we're sitting here talking about our viewers know